On September 14, 2015, the LIGO Observatory detected something that had already been predicted by Einstein in his general theory of relativity. So, he said that gravity is a consequence of distortion caused by mass. So, this means that it actually took 100 years and an observatory built specifically for detecting these distortions to actually detect them. The distortions were called gravitational waves, and it took 5 months after the discovery to confirm them. So, what are gravitational waves? They are ripples in the space-time fabric that transport only energy and not mass, just as any kind of wave. So, it's like the space-time fabric was actually a real fabric, a mesh. So, they would travel at the speed of light and they would affect everything in their path, only not in a noticeable way. For example, this mesh right here has a blue part in the middle. So, imagine that this blue part is the Earth. So, when a gravitational wave comes by, we move and it is it's like we pull from both sides and it stretches. So, it moves like this and it affects everything in its path. So, how are gravitational waves created? They are created by bodies with extreme mass moving at extreme velocities, for example supernovas or neutron stars. But still, these are too weak, so we cannot detect them with our current machinery. So we needed two black holes merging to actually detect them. These black holes were 30 solar masses and 35 solar masses each, and they created as much as 3.6 times 10 to the 49th watts of power, that is bigger than all the stars of the observable universe together. And if we add those up, we notice that 30 plus 35 is 65, and the black hole created was 62 solar masses, which means that 3 solar masses were missing. Where did they go? Well, these solar masses were transformed into gravitational waves, and so billions of years later we detected them, and hence all the gravitational wave discovery. If they are such small disturbances, how can we actually detect them? It was a rather ingenious idea. They built a machine called an interferometer that is made of two very long arms located in an L-shaped structure. There was a laser beam located here, directed towards a beam splitter, and guess what it does? Yes, correct! It splits the beam in two, directs one towards the mirror and the other one towards the other mirror. When the beam gets to the black mirror here, it rebounds on it and goes towards the opposite direction. So, as both arms are precisely the same length, both beams should take the same time to get to the detector, and in normal circumstances, they do. When this happens, they collide in such a way they cancel each other, and the detector has nothing, and that's called destructive interference. But imagine a gravitational wave comes around. Then, as the length of the arms changes, and that's because the wave deforms it, but only for fractions of a second, the light beam takes different times to get to the photodetector, and instead of cancelling out, they create a much more powerful beam, which is recorded, and that's called constructive interference. And that's what happened in the LIGO laboratory. That stands for Laser Interferometer Gravitational Wave Observatory. And there's two observatories. There's one in Livingston, Louisiana, and one in Hanford, Washington, that are very, very far away, but recorded the phenomenon at almost the same time, only 0.7 milliseconds away.